To be honest, it feels like it's only been about 2 months since Christina was released. However, today, Crunchyroll has announced that we will be getting our second Princess Gala banner on this 20th of December. And so for all of you who have been like saving up or like who could not get the Christina the first time, this is it, my guys. And so hopefully your perseverance is going to pay off and you're able to get both of them in your 300 draws if you really need to go that far. Hi, welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace and today we're going to be talking about the new update. We've got the Princess Gala, we've got a couple of other things, and we've got some information that was not given to us via Crunchyroll, via official channels that may or may not be happening. We're going to be discussing UE, we're going to be discussing a lot of different things, a new event, and so without further ado, let's just jump into the content. Alright, and so to kick things off, again, Princess Gala, double 3-star draw rates. If you are hunting for DA, this is where you're going to hunt for it. If you did the strat where you skip the Christina banner to hopefully get both New Year's UE banner as well as Christina on this banner, then congratulations, we finally made it. But otherwise, from here on out, these Princess Gala banners, they're gonna come probably like every 2 or 3 months, and it's gonna be a great time because our DA income overall is probably going to actually be increasing from here on out. And so I'm just gonna skip through most of this. New Year's UE, Christina, 100% must pulls. And the last thing I do want to say about this one is that, again, this gala is only going to return for 72 hours. So I know last time, I think a couple of people got cucked. They waited a few days, they were doing daily draws or whatever. And then the Princess Gala banner last time for Christina just went poof. All right, so that's it for the Princess Gala banner. So the New Year's UE. New Year's UE is Pimp. And if you guys don't know what New Year's UE does, she essentially turns into like the ultimate healer, the ultimate survivability cheat code. Absolutely destroys her own offensive capabilities to boost everybody's defensive capabilities. And honestly, that sounds freaking awesome to me. She will see a lot of use, especially in PvE. I'm not 100% sure about CB. Honestly, I freaking doubt it because that kind of sounds weird. And depending on your brackets, you may also be seeing her in arena. Probably more probable in the princess arena than the battle arena. All right, and so I do want to point this out. December 20 to December 23rd for this Princess Gala banner, we're going to then switch over to a solo New Year's UE banner for the next like 2 weeks after that. And so there may be a scenario where you do want to roll on this. Maybe you hit Christina early or something, but to be honest, like the double rates on this one over here, the Princess Gala is always gonna be the more value one. I'm pretty sure that the New Year's UE rate, like the 0.7%, is going to actually be the same across these two banners. But again, the value in this one, you just cannot ignore it. And so therefore, nobody should be pulling on this solo banner. We have Valentine Shizuru right after that, as well as like New Year's Hiyori or whatever, but it's all good. Let's move on. And so here we've got the daily free 10 draw. If you guys remember from the last video, it started from the X Ayane banner. We're going to get about 70 on that, and then we're going to get 40 from here. So just remember, on about like the 20th of December, you need to not roll for the Ayane. And then after the arena cutoffs, for me, it's like 9 a.m. in the morning, we're going to like lapse over. For me personally, and I think you guys have been enjoying this quite a fair bit actually, if I don't manage to get the New Year's UE on these free 10 pulls, so that's about like 40 pulls, honestly pretty doubtful, then please do expect a stream. And I don't know, maybe the boys will want to come and stream as well if they were as unlucky as I was. But otherwise, it's all good things here. And so let's move on to the next one, Twinkle Crisis. And so for this event, we will be focusing on the Twinkle Wish characters. So we got Rei, we got Yui, as well as the Hiyori. And for you guys who don't know, I believe the last Princess Connect, the non-redive one, was based around these characters actually. And so this will be a pretty cool one. However, I think it's going to be like kind of the same, so we're just going to go through and fight the normal very hard and hard bosses. Yep, exclusive boss battle, so that means that we're just going to be getting the boss tickets, we're going to be consuming the boss tickets, and then we're going to be rolling on those boxes. However, what is really nice about this one is that we will be getting New Year's Rei as the welfare unit. And in this case, we got to discuss, like, is she like a summer Kokoro where she is used everywhere, or is she more like a summer Mifuyu who looks nice on the home screen? New Year's Rei, as you can see, she's looking real good over there, so of course she's gonna look great on the home screen. But in terms of like viability, I think she does definitely see some use in arena. And so I know that some people are going to be gunning for like the 5-star New Year's Rei by refreshing the stage 115 to be able to farm the boss tickets so that they can keep running the normal boss over and over, no sorry, the hard boss, so that they can keep refreshing the victory medal gacha for that last box. If you guys remember, the last box gives 3 of the welfare shards. So what would my recommendation on this be? If you really like her and if you do envision yourself using her for Arena, then I would say go for 4-star. However, if you're able to like one hit or two hit, generally speaking, you're probably going to be able to get her to 3-stars, which I think that's what I'm going to be doing. As much as I like New Year's Ray, I am always very cautious, especially in terms of like refreshing these events, because like it's about to get real hectic over here, right? We've got Valentine Shizuru again, and I don't know how many times I can stress this. We've got Muimi over here, and then we've got Kasumi, and then we've got Anne, and then we've got maybe a Ninon Oedo. But then after that, we've got the two ReZero collab characters, and then we've got all of the summer characters. Summer Suzuna, Summer Saren, Summer Makoto, Summer Maho, and then Neneka. Like, yeah, there's quite a lot going on. So for me personally, I'm always just very wary. I'm always very like paranoid that I'm not going to hit these characters. So I don't think I will do it, but like it's only, I believe, like a 10 pull cost in terms of refreshing. So for New Year's Ray, you definitely could. You definitely could not. But then we've got this event quest player EXP 1.5 times. So therefore, and combined with these free pulls, it is a great time to start, my guys. If you guys are watching this video for some reason and you guys are still not playing this game, then yeah, I would highly recommend it. Reroll for Christina or New Year's Yui or both. I probably would go for both and then blast through the story with this 1.5 times EXP. But otherwise, pretty straightforward, pretty cookie cutter stuff for the event. And so lastly, let's talk about the new unique equipment coming out. This was a little bit fast, I must admit that. All right, so as you can see, we've got Arisa, Tamaki, Yukari, Akino, Mifuyu, and Ninon. So let me hop over to, you know, your girl's Miss Niara sheet. And so here you can see, this is the second batch of the unique equipment. So Yukari at the highest in terms of craft priority and leveling priority, and then also la-di-da-di-da. So I do want to talk about all of these because I prioritize some things a little bit different to other people, and I want to work through this one. So the undisputed top priority is always Yukari. Yukari being a one cost unit, it's so surprising how she always manages to top the priority lists. The reason she is so good is because she provides like all of the support that we could ever want, right? We want the magic defense shield, we want the single target heals, we want the TP boost. And so what happens with Yukari is that her single target heals pretty much doubles. Essentially it doubles, but on top of that, you also get a regen heal over time. And so this just really, really like boosts the survivability of every single comp that she will ever lay her feet into. That's probably, in my opinion, the better part of the UE, but the extra effect that we get, as we always do, for the target that Yukari heals, she buffs their M defense by 80 for 12 seconds. I don't know if you guys like realize how much 80 is. Like, I'm pretty sure, what's her name, Miyako's physical defense is like, let's say 330, something like that. And so as you can imagine, like 80 M defense is quite significant actually. But on top of that, not only is her UE like super, super cracked, leveling the UE is even more cracked. Because as you can see, attack 477, up 300 attack from the level 30 versus 130, and then HP boost plus 90. She is a healing machine. Although it's not going to let her heal faster, she is going to be healing like an insane amount. And do remember that healers actually do scale their heals off of attack. It is certainly part of the equation. And so this attack stat, it is definitely not useless. All right, so next we've got Arisa. I do know that I believe for a lot of like the top 10 or top 25, Arisa is certainly a must UE character. So for me, the most interesting thing about her UE is that it actually doubles in damage. So you can already imagine where Arisa and like Tamaki, these characters, they target those mage characters. And so because they're targeting those mage characters and then they're now doing more damage, this skill one is going to be more often than not killing people now. However, on top of that, we've got the decrease in the action speed by 20%, which is always superb, especially for Arena. And a lot of the time it's debuffing like those really annoying mages like your Eeyore or like your Hatsune. And then as for the UE effect itself, it debuffs its M attack with 375 for 12 seconds, just lowering the threat of those freaking mages. Me personally, I think that Arisa is a great character. I do think that she is a very good priority, but if we are talking from like a PvP point of view, I do think that two other units are higher priority simply because they actually are going to be changing the entire dynamic. But before we get to that, let me just quickly finish this one off. Level medium priority, but look at that. Look at that attack. She's gaining 500 attack as well as 80 crit. That is super, super spicy. All right, so next we've got Ninon and Tamaki, who I was just referring to. So Ninon is going to get almost double damage on her skill one, as well as this bad boy over here. And so what I meant by like changing the dynamic if Ninon kills somebody with the skill 1, she is pretty much going to be able to UB. In some situations, in some matchups, I definitely know that Ninon uses her skill 1s to kill, like for example, the Ilyas. And so with this skill, if she actually succeeds, what this means is that Ninon's skill, her UB, which probably would have taken an extra like 5 seconds to charge or something, she's just going to use it instantly. And then as for the levels, like 30 attack, 233 crit, 37, again, very similar to Iris's, we are getting 500 attack approximately and like about 80 of the crit. I think Ninon UE is fantastic. However, I'm probably a bigger fan of the Tamaki UE. And so Tamaki UE, as you can see, skill 1 does not seem to actually have any of the damage boost. However, it is going to get a little bit more spicy for the mages again. So debuffs the M attack by 275 or 550 with the UE for 12 seconds. But the part that I like the most, which really does like change the matchups a lot, is this one over here, which is stuns for 1.5 seconds. Honestly, this is like really, really freaking big, because if you can already imagine, like Hatsune stuns on her skill 1, she is pretty much like the Tamaki of mages. And a lot of the time, these stuns are just so freaking massive, especially when we're in an era of like, oh, if you have one less TP retain or TP gain, then you gotta wait another action to be able to get the full TP bar, to get like your UV off. It's freaking crazy. And so for me, you guys already know, I'm a massive fan of the utility in the arenas, and so Tamaki, she is almost certainly going to be a slam for me. And then after that, we've got the Mifuyu as well as the Akino. And I do want to make something like very, very clear about all of these characters, like these highlighted red ones, like this one over here, or like even this one over here. All UEs are always good. It's just that with our limited resources, especially when we don't have like the 2x Sanctum or anything yet, we still need to prioritize like unlocking some of them and then leveling some of them before we can just slam it on everybody. So yeah, Mifuyu with the UE, I must admit, I have fallen for a lot of different Mifuyu tricks, but unfortunately, generally speaking, Mifuyu and Akino, they are just outclassed by the rest of these. And so that brings me to my almost next point, or my last point, which is the next clan battle. So there was nothing mentioned explicitly, you know, over here there was no mention of clan battle or when it's gonna be. And with clan battle starting in like 1 day or 2 days, you would expect it to be in about a month's time, something like that, right? So about maybe the 20th of January. I have seen some rumors, you know, just in the community, people talking, people whispering. Some people are speculating, or like based on some data that they got from somewhere, that clan battle, the next clan battle after the one that's about to happen, it is going to start on the about the 5th of January, which is that gives you about 2 weeks from the end of this CB till the next CB. And so we can interpret that like in a couple of different ways, right? Like if we get more CBs, it technically means that we're going to be hopefully getting more gemmies. And so all of this mad rush will hopefully be a little bit less scary. On the other hand, a lot of people would rather chill. You let me know which bucket you are in. But with that little piece of information, that is going to actually bring us to the end of this video. So it's time for you guys to let me know, how are you guys doing on your free X Ayane pulls? Me personally, I'm recording them, and so you'll know how I do, but I want to know how you guys are going. And on top of that, assuming that the clan battle rumors are true, we do get like a 2 week gap. Let me know what you think about it. And if you guys would be so kind as to leaving a comment down below, I would really, really appreciate that, because it means you've watched up until the end of the video. So thank you guys so much. But otherwise, you already know what it is. Please like the video if you did like it, and if you would like to see more of me, and if you still have not, which is kind of weird, then please subscribe. But otherwise, as your girl Gomen Yui once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.